There's a long-standing belief in medicine that coffee and caffeine can mess up the rhythm of your heart and cause or worsen a condition called arrhythmia. To push out blood effectively, the fibers of your heart muscle need to contract in sync. But up to 1 in 3 people over the lifetime suffer from this condition where the fibers are asynchronous. Arrhythmias can be dangerous. They can cause strokes or heart failure. And people who suffer from arrhythmia historically were often advised to avoid coffee and caffeine in general because, or so we thought, caffeine can trigger or worsen arrhythmias. Well, all my coffee fans rejoice because that belief just changed. Researchers at UCSF took 200 patients with the most common form of arrhythmia called atrial fibrillation, or AFib for short, and they split them randomly, and they had half of them abstain from coffee or caffeine products for 6 months, while the other half were supposed to have them daily. The first group averaged 0 cups of coffee a day for those 6 months. The second group averaged 1 cup of coffee a day. Over those 6 months, the folks consuming the coffee and the caffeine actually had less, not more, instances of atrial fibrillation. They were 39% less likely to experience AFib than the abstainers. After they adjusted for some characteristics like BMI, medication, etc., the effect became a little stronger still, a 42% reduction in risk of arrhythmia in coffee drinkers. And adverse effects were the same in both groups. Nothing was significantly worse in the group that drank the coffee. So this is the first randomized trial specifically looking at this question, and it essentially flips our understanding of this. It's fascinating. This doesn't happen every day in science. Sometimes we see this early in a field when all we have is educated guesses, and then there's the first rigorous test, and it sometimes surprises us. This is the beauty of science, and this is why we test things. In general, we see less heart disease, total heart disease, in coffee drinkers than non-coffee drinkers. But there was always this specific concern of the arrhythmias because of the postulated action of caffeine in the nerves and in synchrony of the heart muscle. And so this trial now contradicts that entirely. So the data for arrhythmia is now pointing in the same direction of all the other heart disease data for coffee, that coffee might actually be protective. We always apply some caution with a single trial, and this trial has limitations like any trial ever, although the authors did a pretty good job of plugging the holes. So the balance of evidence now points towards coffee being beneficial for people with arrhythmia rather than harmful. I know there's going to be lots of additional questions. What about decaf? What about instant versus brewed coffee? This is the first trial on this question, guys. So this is so far all we know. More to come. How does coffee achieve this? One possibility is that caffeine acts directly on the nerves to affect heart muscle contraction. Another possibility is that coffee has been shown to have an anti-inflammatory effect, and so that may help prevent arrhythmias, atrial fibrillation. Another possibility is that caffeine makes us move more. You just get more fidgety, there's more physical activity in general, and that may help reduce atrial fibrillation. If you have AFib or any type of arrhythmia, talk to your doctor about this new research. It might actually make sense to try to get some coffee and some caffeine instead of avoiding it. But definitely check with your doctor first. This is brand new, so you want to personalize. Also, careful with too much caffeine if you have sleep issues, if you have caffeine sensitivity, high blood pressure, and if you're pregnant, you want to avoid an excess of caffeine. For a lot more on heart disease and coffee, check out this previous video, and I'll see you in there.